Middletown, a quiet American community. After a busy day at the office, the shop, or perhaps one of the local plants, but some plants, like this newspaper, operate 24 hours a day. Yes, news is always in the making. Mad dog bites 18 here.
Here's a special announcement. The County Health Department has declared an epidemic of rabies in Butler County. 89 cases of rabies in dogs have occurred in the county during the past 3 months. And 165 persons have received vaccine treatment. Today, 18 people were bitten by one rabid dog roaming through Middletown. This dog advises you to wash the wounds with soap and warm running water, then consult your physician or the county health department to determine whether vaccine treatment will be required. The county health department has called in Dr. Joseph Fisher, the state public health veterinarian, and Dr. Burton Richards, the rabies control expert from the United States Public Health Service, to set up emergency control measures. If you are the owner of a dog who's been bitten, take your pet to the nearest animal clinic or humane shelter for vaccination. Authorities say that once rabies develops in man or animal, it is 100% fatal. Get in touch with your physician or veterinarian as soon as possible. Be sure to keep your pets indoors until the county health department declares that this epidemic is under control. For further news, stay tuned to this station.
This dying animal, paralyzed and helpless, has caused fear, anxiety, and costly damage in Middletown. Picked up by the dog warden, the dog is taken to the local humane shelter for observation. The dog died and its head was sent to the health department. Here, in a small, isolated room, the brain is removed from the skull for examination for positive evidence of rabies. It is safe to delay human vaccine treatment, provided that laboratory facilities are immediately available. Diagnosis is determined by the finding of Negri bodies within any portion of the brain-containing nerve cells. But Negri bodies are most prevalent in the Ammon's horn. The dog had rabies. Dr. Brown was notified immediately and injections began. 14 painful injections, one every day. The strain took its toll of the parents as well as the child. Tommy would get well. 18 people in Middletown would get well. But they would always remember that once rabies develops, it's 100% fatal. In the meantime, the emergency program to control the epidemic was in full swing.
Protect human lives. Prevent rabies. Protect human lives. Prevent rabies. Your dog vaccinated today. Have your dog vaccinated against rabies today.
Through the cooperation of the entire community, 80% of all dogs were immunized in 1 week. The emergency control program showed excellent results. Although these were emergency animal clinics, they were set up with authorized procedures for inoculating all dogs in any community, in any state. Standard vaccination certificates were issued by the County Health Department. Owners were advised to inoculate their dogs at least once a year, to keep their dogs on leashes or confined at home for 30 days until the vaccine was fully effective. All dogs were inoculated with a vaccine approved by the U.S. Bureau of Animal Industry. With rabies under control, the people of Middletown were determined to keep it out of the community for good. The state public health veterinarian called a meeting of all private practicing veterinarians, physicians, public health officers, and leading citizens to set up a permanent long-range control program in every community in the state.
And for that reason, we have asked Dr. Richards to explain how the United States Public Health Service is coping with this problem.
We know how to control rabies. Other countries have done so. We can do the same. Our foreign quarantine measures require the inoculation of all dogs entering the United States. Yet, millions of our own dogs are unprotected. Stray dogs must be reported to the local health departments and properly impounded in humane shelters. Rabies in wild animals is also an important problem in many parts of the country. Our U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service is helping the states carry out trapping programs during epidemics of rabies. Every year, millions of dollars are lost by dairy farmers and cattle breeders. Thousands of injections are given to people bitten by rabid dogs. Parents and children suffer in fear. This need not be. We must recognize the seriousness of rabies. We must assume a personal responsibility. Have our own dogs inoculated, and then get the rest of the community to do the same. Then the states, and the states themselves, must join the National Rabies Control Program. We can win the fight against rabies.